Everybody, this is Liz James with Houston Street Kings. I'm sitting here in the studio with the legendary Papa Ru.
Yeah.
I'll let the people.
You already know what it is, man. Houston Street Kings. That's what's up. You know what I mean? That's what's up. Man.
All right. People want to know, though.
You want to know, like, where I've been?
Where have you been, man? Where have you been?
Well, you know, that's one of the main questions they ask me, man. You know, well, you know, I've been around for a minute. For a lot of people who don't know who I am, it's P-A-P-A-R-E-U. Just want y'all to make sure you spell it the right way, because you might be putting me as, you know, ain't no telling what's going to come up when you put R-E-A-U-X and R-O-U. Anyway, for the viewers, it's P-A-P-A-R-E-U, Papa Ru. I mean, that's the name. And it's short for my real name. That's a trivia question.
But where you been, though?
So, you know, I've been waiting on y'all to come over here.
What you been doing lately? Well,
on a serious note, what I've been doing, I really had pulled back a little to create what I created now, which is the Born to Win 365 album. You know what I mean? I did over like 50 songs, you know, to really pick the best 15, 16, you know, because, you know, when you leave off the scene on a certain level, you know, you got to try to top that where you left off. You can't come back playing, you know. So, you know, where I left off was pretty much to put it in the air with the Rick Ross. You know, the put it in the air.
You know,
I left off right there. Then I came back with the new Scarface album, but I featured on there. The put it in there was my record. The Scarface Deeply Rooted album. Big ups to Big Bro Scarface. You know what I mean, Brad? What's happening? You know what I mean? The Deeply Rooted album, did a couple joints on there. So, you know, coming off of that is the Born to Win 365.
So basically you just been behind the scenes?
Yeah, just been behind the scenes, whipping up that, we can cuss on you? That shit.
Nobody whips shit, you know what okay, man? That's nasty.
You know what I mean? Well, you whip shit up so good till you want to eat that thing, you know what I mean? That's how good you can whip it up, you feel me?
Bro.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, so let's go back to your roots. Let's go back to the original young Papa Ru. How you got into it, you know, where you came from.
Well, pretty much, I'm originally from the island of Trinidad and Tobago. That's in the Caribbean Islands. For people who don't know, that's between North and South America. There's a string of islands in between.
Caribbean.
And it's the Caribbean. You know, we got Rihanna, she's from Barbados. We got, you know, Sean Kingston, Jamaica. We got, Nicki Minaj, she's from where I'm from, Trinidad and Tobago, Trinidad Jane from, you know, there's a lot of islands, you know, with the hip hop, you know, with the hip hop trend, you know, Drake always over in the islands, you know what I mean? So, you know, the island influence. But anyway, coming from Trinidad, I came straight to Houston, you know what I mean? Which is crazy because most island people go to the East Coast.
Like Miami.
Yeah. And the East Coast. So that's what started to make me who I am and to be different in the industry. Reason being, I was from the islands and I came to Houston.
Houston has
I'm talking about slowed
culture.
Up. I'm talking about
Screw.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Speaking of that, RIP DJ Screw today.
Yeah, and to come with the island sound and make it fit in Southern rap. And
totally different.
And I'm going to stamp this right now in Houston Street King, and it's the first time I'm saying it. I was the one that originated Southern reggae.
Oh, yeah?
I stamped that today. Nobody talked about it. You had all kind of tabloids, and nobody never said who was the first island person to mix reggae with
Houston,
rap. Not even Houston with rap.
Yeah.
Because with Cash Money, you know, I was with Lil Wayne, the big timers. All I was the first. I'm the original. You know what I mean? So y'all getting it first right here on Houston Street King. That's an exclusive line right there. Publish that.
put it in the air.
Shout to niggas.
I want you to put them up. No. Put it in the air.
Let's go.
When you came to Houston, you mixing reggae, rap sound, American rap, you know, you mentioned Cash Money. Is that like the first major record label that you...
Like the first major feature that I ever done?
Yeah.
No, not really, because when I came over, one of the first features I done is, I remember was with Rap-A-Lot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was with Rap-A-Lot, and I was with DMG, was one of Face's artists, I think. With the Rigor Mortis album, I remember it like yesterday.
DJ.
Yeah, so that's deep. Big ups to Rap-A-Lot. You know what I'm saying? And then after that, I did with Suave House, with 8-Ball MJG on the Outside Looking In album.
Yeah,
you have a song on it. We lick our shot, lick him up shot.
That's
me. I was a little toddler.
But that's
so
where
you know
came
what I mean?
From. That's where you started
so
from.
I started from there, and then I did a feature with Cash Money came out here. They was working in the studio out here, and how the link happened was at Club Butter. I remember that like yesterday.
Man.
And we had a mutual friend that just, you know, hey, this Papa Roo, you know, he be doing this thing. Blah, blah. Then hey, you know, and Juvie and I loved reggae.
Yeah.
And really and truly, Juvie was really the link for me over there, because Juvie was like, hey man, look, come by the studio tomorrow, man, come in. Oh, and then I went over there to holler at Juvie. And then we just start going outside and we doing our thing, yeah. And boom, yeah. And then, you know, he loved my flavor, so he's feeding off of each other. End up doing a couple features with them, and it was history after that.
Yeah, and here you are.
Yeah, here I am, Papa Roo, you know what I mean?
That's
original.
What's up?
Yeah.
That's what's up. Carcass on my side, yard weed in the jar, got a good pound of brown. I'm the top shot to that, I knock your ass down, put my feet on the ground. The high power. Beep, beep comes the sound of my You know, you come from the old school, you know, age of hip hop, and what you think about this new stuff that they have out now they call hip hop?
Well, I pretty much give them their props too, you know, I mean, to be honest with you. Reason being, you know, things evolve.
They evolve.
You know, they doing what they do, and they captivating people by doing what they do. But the only thing I just don't respect about everything is that, you know, most of them is not really, you know, they're not listening to most of the OGs. Like, if we should have, if the hip hop game, you know, most, like, say all one, each OG grab a youngster. Each OG, they should do it, all them reality shows they got, why they don't do something like that?
Yeah.
Each OG, let DMX go grab Lil Yachty. Let Nas go grab name another one.
I don't know none of them.
Okay, well, no, I'm just saying Lil Uzi. I'm just saying something like that. And because these are OGs with knowledge. They'll go and say, hey, you're doing what you're doing, but hey, make sure you make good for the community.
Right.
Don't matter what kind of music you're making, as long as you're doing good for the community, you're doing your job for our people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, man, is you know, we try to dissect, oh, how it sound like that. How it ain't really about the music and how it sound. It's really about what are you doing now for the community.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Y'all got the new sound now. That's cool. You know what I mean? But you making the money now. That's cool. But what are you doing for the next ones that's about to come up?
Right.
But you see what I'm saying? But they're doing a lot of crash dummy stuff.
Yeah.
So that's why it's making us look at them like y'all are this and y'all are that and this. Because if they were doing stuff and being positive, you know, if you see them every weekend doing charity for the this or doing, we would look at them a whole different way.
Yeah.
But to do music like that and to be on Instagram and all that doing stuff, you know what I mean, that's making it go way out of the left field. You know what I'm saying? It just don't add up, man. So, you know.
I'm gonna give it to you like this. Papa Roo and Lil Kiki the Don. Southside most wanted, baby. You, girl, and be with you.
You know, y'all looking all beautiful things, but it look from your face, you're a little bit stressed out. You need a player that's internationally known, nationally recognized, and locally accepted.
I'll never, never leave you, girl. Light up my life like diamonds and pearl. I'll never, never leave you, girl. The loving in my heart could I never grow old. I'll never, never leave you, girl. You light up my life like diamonds and pearl. I'll never, never leave you, girl. The loving in my heart could I never grow old.
Alright, look, we in here in your recording booth.
Mm-hmm, my little
while
space.
We in here, let us know what projects you got coming on.
Yeah.
You know, what to look out for.
Well, right now, you know, like I said, you know, I took a leave off of that, put it in the air. And, you know, the new project, Born to Win 365, I mean, working on it for the past 2.5 years. You know, I got over 16 joints. Got all Houston on there. We got Paul Wall on there, Killer on there. You know, I got Zero on there. Got Chameleon there on there. You know, one thing I always do is make sure I keep my Houston brothers on there. Scarface on there. You know what I mean? So I always keep my Houston brothers with me. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I plan to take them in the international sound. That's the mesh that I'm doing. Taking the Houston, you know what I mean? Because I know how to do it. Because I understand the sound. I came from the sound.
Right.
So, you know, so the Born to Win 365 is what's up for this, for 2018. You know what I mean? Look out for that.
Right.
Look out for that.
Well, speaking of Houston, cause we Houston Street Kings, mm-hmm. Let us know what your definition of a Houston Street King is.
Well, definition of a Houston Street King is pretty much a congratulator. When I say a congratulator, because, you know, a lot of things stems down from that. You know what I mean, when you're a congratulator, you can become a boss because you know how to value stuff. You know what I mean? And that's the difference with people nowadays. To be honest with you, when it comes to being a boss and being a what do you call it, a worker. Okay, when it comes
employee.
To being a boss, when it comes to be a boss and an employee,
yeah.
You know, it's got some people that's not cut out to be a boss.
Right.
Some people not cut out to be an employee.
Leaders and followers.
You know what I mean? But they both need each other.
Go hand in hand.
And that's the key to it. They both need. So the bottom line is to be a Houston Street King, you got to understand how to give and how to receive.
Got to understand how to balance.
And how to balance.
I see.
You know what I mean? And that's a big umbrella for it.
That's interesting. And I haven't heard that one before, but that's real good, though.
Yeah, it's a big umbrella for it. It's a big one.
With your big broad hips, exquisite figure, oh man, are you? Me want for be me daughter. For kiss up your lips, rub down your structure. Put your inner me bed, that make me start for tremor. Skin next to you, that make me feel vulgar. Oh man, you know you want me.
What do you think that we need to do to get Houston back on top, back on the map, you know, everything we've been through?
You know, one thing about Houston, I must say, is that, you know, we always come up, we always trendsetters. I'm always tell you that. We always been trendsetters. The only problem we always had was we tend to set the trend and divert instead of setting the trend and come together. So what it is, people take it and make it better than us. Only because we didn't come together and take it to be the greatness that it's supposed to be. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was one of our biggest downfall. And you know what I mean? I preach that to everybody I talk to when it comes to the city. You know what I mean? And like I said, I'm one of them cats that always in my own little lane and, you know, I try to change that. Because look, they had Akon before Akon. But why didn't the city go ahead and, you know what I mean? Just look at it. I've been doing this before and I came from right here, from H-Town. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm telling you is we are trendsetters. How we don't know he listened to me?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I know. That's what I'm telling you. So all I'm saying is for the city to get back together, to get back on top on where we used to be, is that we really got to look at ourselves as entertainers. I'm not going to even put it as the fans. We got to look into ourselves as entertainers, meaning myself, you know what I mean? And know that, hey, we need to do this together. You know what I mean? When an event come down, man, all of us should be there. It should be an automatic. When Slim doing something, everybody there. When Zero there, everybody there. It's not a question. We calling in, hey, man, I ain't going to be able to make. You know, we should be in the habit of calling in, hey, man, I ain't going to make this one, bro. But y'all hold it down. Blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? We should be that much together. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you know, I'm going to do my part to do that. You know what I mean? That's why I'm here doing my interview with the Houston Street Kings. You know what I mean? I'm going to do my part for y'all. Now, I mean, and wherever it takes, wherever then, y'all already know the ones that, hey, that, you know what I mean, that want the best for what y'all are doing. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it is. And once you keep that kind of energy, man, you got to keep that going. And it's a wrap. H-Town, Born to Win 365, Papa Rule. Yeah, yeah!
Alone, I'm ball faded, plus the roof is missing. I'm in my slab now, but usually roll Texas.